Right now, what we're seeing are a series of issues. Central banks are willing to diminish support. China is facing a new slowdown. There are bottlenecks everywhere, which all of us are experiencing. There's a variety of things that are being delayed in terms of fiscal spending plans. And ultimately, of course, none of this has caused an equity market correction for anything over the last 12 months.
These pressures that we're seeing right now due to a distorted economy and maximum stimulus are coming down. So slower growth, slower inflation, continued expansion as a base case view.
There really is no point that we see over the course of the next 15 months where this young global expansion is going to fade. While earnings growth is slowing, the amount of earnings that are being generated is growing and growing considerably. And we think that there is further EPS growth available to see in 2022.
But there are also risks around those views. We have seen some concern for the growth rate. This is mostly emanating out of China is the obvious one. And there are also interest rate risks at the same time. These might counteract, but we might have both growth risks, rate risks, or both relative to our base case.
We're already past our peak growth rates, meaning that the pandemic occurred, the stimulus occurred, that money is now sitting in the bank. And from here on out, we're going to go back to a regular economy, which requires deceleration. And you can see that in a whole variety of sectors. But the one that we want to highlight for you is the fact that industrials have peaked, but healthcare, right, that opportunity actually remains incredibly strong. And why does it remain strong? It's because of the sustainability that healthcare has versus cyclicals.
Over the course of the coming year, and especially into 2023, there are industries that are just likely to see less volatility, less of a slowdown from a year-to-year basis. And these are the things, again, that should have, I think, a higher rating in markets, sustainable end demand, whereas these swings from bust to boom are less sustainable.
There's no indication that there's going to be any slowdown in investment in technology hardware, but most importantly, in software, where we're going to see the necessary sustained investment by businesses that want to remain competitive in software services. And the combination of hardware spending and software spending, we think, is on nothing but a sustainable upward trend.
We really haven't built up, I think, the kind of cyclical risk that we did during the telecom boom. The build out of internet infrastructure in the late 1990s period, you just don't have that kind of a catalyst for a deep correction in technology.
When we take all of this and put it together, the inflationary pressures that people are worried about broadly are going to diminish. The supply chain issues are ultimately going to resolve themselves.
We are taking a view here that while we're going to get the bulk of our return from equities, we're still expecting high single-digit returns over the next 12 months. We want to take a look at long-term investing in private equity and real estate for some returns. But 28% is not where we're going to be in the coming year. And there are risks that would have us at least have some low-risk capital within our wealth that we're holding on the sidelines.